Chateau de Boeuf. Do you think we can afford this stuff?
Sure. $1.99 a bottle. All right, the store says it's good stuff.
Just think, this time tomorrow, Grace and Logan are going
to
be
married. I really wanted to get champagne, but we just didn't have enough on our account. We saved everything we have to get home. Whenever the time is right.
Mm-hmm. You're thinking a lot about home these days, aren't you?
I just want to know exactly what's going on back there, that's all. By the way, I called Seth and told him about that weird call from Meg.
Did he tell you why he and Freddie canceled the wedding?
No, he didn't say anything, but then I asked him about Mama. And he didn't want to talk about it. I think he's real worried about her.
You're worried about her too, aren't you?
Yeah. Ready or not, here comes the party.
Oh, look at this.
Last night, the how good, buddy. Tomorrow afternoon, you're going to be fitted out for a bowl and chain.
Oh, no way, pal. Grace and I have just begun the how.
Wow.
See, and you say marriage kills romance.
Now, don't you get no ideas, Jeannie. I'm happy with the things the way they are. Besides, Romeo here made me an offer that I could not refuse for his share of the rig. He'd only be seeing me once a month on the flip-flop.
Now, don't you pay any attention to Warren, Jeannie. I give him 6 months at the longest.
Oh, yeah.
Let's sing a toast to the bride.
Oh, there you go.
Come on, lady. Hold on with that toast until we have some genuine champagne here. You ready for D-Day, Gracie?
Would you buy out the whole store, Lance?
Well, you
know. Oh, well, I mean, we know that Lily and Holden are throwing this party, but...
Well, we just want to make sure everything got done up just right. These folks are only going to get married once, you.
Yes, they are, and this party was our present to Gracie.
Oh, speaking of presents, Lordy, I almost forgot. Woo! Loretta! Loretta, racked my brain trying to figure out what to get you all, and suddenly it hit me. You all are going to want to take a honeymoon. So, Loretta, everybody, Loretta.
Hi, Loretta, how are you?
She's going to watch out for this place while you're gone.
Yeah.
Well, Lance, honey, that's just real sweet of you, but I'm sure that Lily and Holden can manage just fine on their own.
Well, now, Gracie, why don't you wait to see what Loretta really does before you turn her down? Hit it, Loretta.
Oh, Lance, you're out. Well, come on.
There you are. Well, you look worse than you did this morning.
Thank you.
Look, Meg, I'm worried about you. I thought you'd feel better after a day at home. Maybe you should see a doctor.
We interrupt this program with a special news bulletin. The notorious James Stenbeck is still at large. However, there's reason to suspect...
I've heard just about enough about James Stenbeck. Look, Meg, what is the matter with you?
Nothing, except the fact that my husband has accused me of having an affair with another man.
If I was wrong, then I apologize.
If? You were dead wrong.
Then I take back what I said.
Oh, just like that. Oh, gosh, I didn't mean it. I didn't mean it when I said you were sleeping around. Just forget it.
Look, Meg, something happened here before I came home last night. Something happened that made you lock our bedroom door. What was it? Look, I'm not accusing you. I'm just concerned.
You were so concerned that you took off for weeks on end and left me here alone. You were so concerned that you took over Craig's business without thinking how it might affect my life.
Are you expecting someone?
No. Tony,
hello. What do you want? I came to see my sister. I understand she was very upset last night when you got home. Where is she?
Seth? Seth, I'm up here.
Well, well, well. If it isn't Mr. McKechnie, the fugitive. Looks like my lucky day.
Hi. And apparently it's not mine, Officer Costello.
Don't try anything stupid, Duncan. I'd hate to have to shoot you in the line of duty.
Award winner, As the World Turns. This portion brought to you today by Bounce, for clothes you can't wait to jump into, and by Pepto-Bismol, coats, soothes, and relieves. Pepto-Bismol for most common stomach discomforts.
Meg, I'm sure Seth would be more comfortable in the living room. Can I get you some coffee?
I really don't have much time. I came to talk to my sister.
All right. Meg tells me that your mother hasn't been feeling well.
She's been overdoing it. We've all been pitching in. She'll be fine.
I hope so. Maybe Meg and I can help out by...
As I explained to Meg, we don't want and can't take any of your money. Now, if she didn't make that clear to you...
No, that's quite clear. Well, now that you aren't marrying Franny, I'm sure you'll have more time to spend at the farm helping your mom. I guess every cloud has its silver lining. I'll be in the study.
I don't like him. Meg. Something is obviously wrong. Is he mistreating you in some way?
No, of course he isn't.
Holden said you sounded very frightened last night when you called on the phone.
So that's why you're here?
Look, if it's not Tonio, then what is it, Josh? I know he's been bugging you.
No, it's not Josh.
Then
either.
What, Meg?
Seth, please.
You had to have a good reason for calling him in the middle of the night. Now, why didn't you call me?
Because you have a lot on your mind with Franny and all.
Then there is something wrong. Meg, I can help you.
No, you can't. Please, it's my problem.
Meg, I love you.
Look. If you love me, please, please don't ask me any more questions, okay? There's nothing you can do to help. I gotta take care of this one on my own.
Oh, now this is some wedding present, Lance. I have never seen one wrapped quite that pretty.
Yeah, well, this girl's got real style.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that ain't all she got.
Oh, I'm sorry, I tried to talk him out of this. It's all right, Mary Pat. Kind of gives me an idea.
Oh, yes, sir.
What's the matter? Don't you like it? It's all perfectly innocent.
Oh, yeah. Oh, 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 oh,
there you go. There you go. I'm done.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, huh.
A toast to women, one and all.
Every inch of them.
Oh, I'll drink to that. Oh.
Okay, girls. And it's our turn. To men.
Here?
Every inch of them.
Oh, she hurts. Oh, she knows how to hurt.
All right, well, Grace, I gotta tell you, I swear I tried to find a pump board for you, but darn it, none of them could dance worth a darn.
Well, that's okay, Lance. I got all the men I can handle right here.
Oh, you silver-tongued devil.
Take it easy now. Skin her back.
Yeah.
You two enjoy this little surprise of mine?
That's what I'd expect from a guy like you, Lance.
Well, thank you, sir. I hope you don't think that I'm horning in on your shindig now. Oh. Nothing like that.
Oh,
I mean,
no.
I would never try to show you up or nothing.
Not at all. Thought never entered my mind. Mm-hmm. Let's go to the jukebox.
Excuse me.
And enjoy the hat.
Mr. Whitaker.
Yeah?
Is that okay?
Oh, Loretta, you did just fine. Now, you see that, buck up there by the jukebox?
Uh-huh.
Well, yeah, the farm boy, yeah. Listen, there's an extra 50 in it for you if you can find a way to distract him from that pretty little filly he's with.
And if those referrals don't work out, please call back. The thing to remember is that you're not alone. Well, we're here to help if you'll let us. Okay. Thanks for calling the hotline. Bye-bye. Can't believe the number of calls we're getting. Not just from teenagers, from adults, too.
Seems like a lot of people out there don't have anybody to talk to.
Yeah, but then they hang up and they're gone. How do we know if we helped or not?
We don't. But just being able to say, I've got a problem, is a big step. It takes a lot to reach out. You know, chances are, if they get that far along, they're that much closer to the next step and then the next step.
Yeah, one step at a time.
Yep.
Well, it helps me, too. Helping them helps me. So much for my unselfish motives.
Oh, Frankie, your motives are just fine. Everybody needs to feel needed.
You talk to Lila?
Nah, we keep missing each other.
Well, don't give up.
Not a chance. How about you? You interested in talking about what really happened between you and Seth?
It's over. That's all.
Well, you wanna go down the hall and call me up on the hotline so I can be anonymous?
It's Sabrina.
What about her?
She's in love with him. I've known about it for a long time. About a week before we were going to be married, Seth and I had a big fight. We've had bigger ones on the same subject, but this time I left to give us both time to cool off. Later that evening, Iva told Seth that she'd seen me swimming down at the pond. So Seth went down there to apologize.
Well, I'm following you so far. I mean, I was at your house the night you came back from the farm, I remember.
It wasn't me at the pond. It was Sabrina.
Oh.
And Seth made up for a fight by making love.
But...
Sabrina never said a word.
Oh.
You see, because we were waiting until...
But if Seth didn't know it was... Yeah. Yeah.
It's not even important anymore. The thing is, Seth finally admitted that he loved her too. So that's the end of our wedding, you know?
I wish there was something wise and wonderful I could say.
Well, I'm just trying not to blame anybody, including myself. I just have to get over it.
Yeah, you will. If you need some help, all you gotta do is reach out and grab hold. Heck, I'm here.
Thanks.
What do you say when we're through here, we go grab a bite to eat somewhere? Hey, how about the Mona Lisa? Oh.
No.
Good enough.
No, that's all right. Seth's not working. Lisa gave him some time off.
Well, Lila's not working either.
Well, if you can handle your ghosts, I guess I can handle mine.
Fair deal.
Snyder, what are you doing here?
Reporting for work, if I still have a job.
Of course you do. I told you, though, take as much time as you need.
I did, and as much as I could afford.
Dear, I was so hoping that maybe you and Fanny...
That's all over now. I have no one to blame but myself. I'll go and change, if that's all right.
Hello, sweetheart.
Oh, what a surprise.
Shannon isn't here by any chance, is she?
Oh, well, yeah, she's right over there with Hal and Margo.
Uh-huh.
I can't believe it. You got out of the Argus before midnight.
Jenkins has everything under control. I wish I could say the same thing about the Falcon mess.
Oh, my poor darling. He's so disappointed that Duncan wasn't the Falcon, Arjun. You spent 4 years of your life just tracking this man down.
Duncan may not be the Falcon, but I know that he's up to something, and I'm going to find out what it is. I'm glad Shannon's here instead of running after him. What do you think that she's discussing with the police, huh?
You know, Duncan may not know that the charges against him have been dropped.
Relax, Shannon. It's all over the television and the radio news. We'll find out about it soon.
But James Stenbeck is still out there, and so is Nick. And Duncan still thinks that Nick is the bumbling rookie, not a killer.
Well, he had us all fooled. Or most of us, anyway.
Well, that's exactly my point. And where would you be if Tom didn't show up when he did today, huh? Huh? Oh, there's Uncle Earl. Maybe he has some news. Excuse me.
Are you okay?
She's right, you know. They could have killed me if Tom hadn't been there. I had no business going in there without a backup yet again.
I might have done the same
thing.
No,
you wouldn't have. You would have done it by the book, we would have had Nick in custody, and we would have nailed James as the Falcon.
Don't worry, we're gonna get Nick, and we're gonna get Stenbeck, too.
I did get him to spill his guts a bit, though. Didn't take much persuading. Oh, he was so smug, you know? Except
what?
Well, I asked him about Lucinda and Emily and Barbara. I wondered whether James had been in contact with them.
Well, you're right. About one of them, anyway.
Barbara.
When I asked you to join me for a drink, Tom, I really wasn't fishing for a dinner invitation.
Oh, do you enjoy eating alone?
Well, not particularly.
Well, neither do I. As district attorney, I thought I'd better make up for some of that grilling you took by the police earlier at Shannon's.
I'm glad to hear that Duncan was cleared of those charges.
Well, I hope he hears the good news himself, wherever he is. Great.
This could get sticky. Do you want to go someplace else?
No.
Well, in that case, I think I'll freshen up a bit before we take a table. Do you mind?
No, sure. I have a phone call to make anyway.
Well, I'm glad they had the good sense to leave.
Could have been a big problem for you if they hadn't.
No. How about ordering me something magnificently gooey and chocolatey for dessert, okay?
See what I can do.
I'll be back in a minute.
Margo, sweetheart.
No, Lisa,
no,
not
tonight.
Not tonight.
I can't do anything about her marriage.
Maybe this will help. What would you like for dinner, Meg?
I'm not hungry.
All right. Are you able to tell your problems to your big brother?
Well, what was I going to say to him? My husband's been accusing me of having an affair? No. No, I didn't say anything to him. He's got enough problems of his own. I don't want to dump mine on him.
Whatever they are.
Oh, just drop it, please.
So I gather your family is still having financial problems.
All right. I'm sorry I didn't say anything about offering money to them. But you have been away an awful long time.
Well, I told you before, Meg, you don't need my permission to spend your half of our money. From the receipts I saw at the office today, you've been spending quite a bit of it while I've been gone. New car, decorating, quite a bill at Fashions.
Oh, great. Now I'm loose with your money as well.
But there was no receipt for money spent to help your family.
Well, Seth told you they wouldn't take the money. My mom as much as said it was dirty money.
Hello? Yes, she's right here. It's for you.
Who is it?
Dr. Michaels, returning your call.
Oh. Dr. Michaels, hi. Thank you very much for calling me back. No, I had a problem. I thought I couldn't work out on my own, but I did, and everything is just fine. I'm sorry to waste your time. Yes, yes, I will. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Oh, I didn't realize how late it was getting. I'll go make you dinner.
Why did you lie to her?
Tony.
And why are you lying to me? Something is very wrong here, Megan. You're not going to leave this room until you tell me what it is.
Hi, Margo.
Taylor.
What do you hear from Lila? I understand from Casey.
Taylor. I don't think we should talk about Lila or Casey.
I hear that you've had a very harrowing day. I understand that if it weren't for Tom, you might not be with us right now. Tom told me the whole story. I think your husband's a very courageous man.
Taylor, I don't think we should talk about Tom either. I don't know how the two of you ended up here for dinner, but it's none of my affair.
It was Tom's idea. Frankly, I think your husband was just interested in a sympathetic ear. It must be difficult for him saving his wife's life and then having her go out to dinner with another man.
And you can smell vulnerability a mile away and go right for it, can't you? Don't hurt him, Taylor.
Tom's already hurting, and it isn't because of me, Margot.
Stop it.
That man adores you, and you've turned your back on him. That sort of thing seems to run in your family, doesn't it?
Just put it on my desk. I'll get to it first thing in the morning. Thank you, Mary. Good night. Now, Mom.
Mom, I am sure there's a perfectly reasonable explanation why you're having dinner tonight with Taylor Baldwin. Or at least I hope there is. But under the circumstances, darling, I think it'd be wise if the two
of
you went over to...
Hold it, Mom. Mom, I'm a grown man. I don't need my mother telling me who I can see and where I can see them.
Well, I hope this doesn't mean that you're actually seeing Taylor, huh?
What would you like me to do? Feel sorry for myself the rest of my life? I'm sorry. I'm sick of beating my head against a brick wall.
Margot is still your wife.
Not for long, she's not. I told you. She made her choice.
I don't believe this. How do you think she's going to feel when she sees you just running around town?
Mom, I am not running around town. I'm having a quiet, civilized, friendly meal with a very attractive woman who happens to enjoy my company. I can't tell you what a great feeling that is.
Really? Well, Thomas Christopher Hughes, I have a few... Excuse me, the kitchen.
Mom, where are you? Hi. I guess you and Hal are in there celebrating.
Tom, I don't think I really got a chance before this to thank you for this afternoon, you know, coming to my rescue.
No, you got a chance. You blew it, it's okay.
Tom.
No, forget it. What I really want you to do is enjoy your meal. I intend to enjoy mine.
Hey, Tom. I don't know how well you know Taylor Baldwin.
Are you in all the details? Where we met, how many times we've been out, what we talked about?
No, I don't really care about the details.
Well, good, I'm glad. It's none of your business anymore.
Tom. Look, I just wanted you to know, I guess, that I don't really trust Taylor. It's,
well, for
it's
your
a long
information,
story.
She's told me about her past history with Casey. All the problems it's caused for Casey and Lila.
Oh, good for her. I just don't think you should trust her completely.
Really? Well, I'm going to tell you what I just told my mom. I'm a grown man. Soon to be a free man. Thanks to you. And I'm just going to try to get my life back together the best way I know how.
I just don't want to see it.
What were you going to say, Margo? Hurt? I'm willing to take my part of the blame for what's happened between us. But what I've done cannot hold a candle to what you've put me through since I've been back. So I suggest that we just end it for both our sakes.
Go ahead without me, Meg. I've lost my appetite.
Tonio, I called Dr. Michaels because when you accused me of having an affair, I just didn't know whether I could handle it. And then, well, you said you believed me. I thought I could, and now I'm really not very sure.
I believe you.
Then why are you acting this way?
Because you're still keeping something from me, and I don't like it.
Well, you keep things from me all the time. For instance, I have no idea why you had to go away for weeks on end. I don't even know what you're reading right now.
It's business.
Business. Well, you keep on reminding me that we're a 50-50 partnership. I guess that means I own 50% of your share of Craig's company, right? I certainly got more than 50% of the flack about it, and I can't even answer anyone's questions.
Believe me, Meg, that's just as well.
Did,
you know while you were in Chicago what Giroux Company was mixed up with?
Mixed up with? Now, what is that supposed to mean?
Well, what exactly is the Giroux Company?
It's a very profitable, rapidly growing outfit. I stand to make a lot of money, half of which will be yours.
Tony, I don't care about the money. Really, I don't. Look, I would be happy if we lost it all tomorrow. Happier.
Meg, don't be naive.
Sometimes I wish I were more naive.
Why all these questions about Giroux tonight?
I'm just curious.
Have I satisfied your curiosity?
Yeah. I think I know all I need to know.
Good. Come on. Let's go have some dinner.
You go ahead. I'll be down in a minute. Working for James Stenbeck. Mama's right. It is dirty money.
Yeah, and I spoke with Meg earlier, and she wouldn't tell me what was wrong, Mama. But she swore it had nothing to do with Tonio, or Josh, for that matter. I don't know, maybe she'll talk to you. I seem to be striking out on all fronts these days.
Poor Seth, he is so sad.
You just want the whole world to be happy.
Oh, well, everyone I love, I want to be happy. Seth and Franny and, well, Lila and Casey. And, every time I come into this place, I think about Craig. Oh, I miss him, Craig and Sierra. And then I think about my son, Tom. He and Margo used to be so happy.
All right, we better head back to the station.
You mind if I go with you? There might be some word about Duncan, huh?
Sure, sure.
Okay, great. I'll be right back.
I saw you talking to Tom in the foyer.
Mm-hmm. Enough said. Listen, if you're so sure that Barbara and Paul have been into contact with James, why didn't you just confront them and force him to cooperate and tell us everything?
No, I think we're better off playing the waiting game right now. I'm sure that Stenbeck is far away from here by now, and I'm just as sure that he's going to be back to get his son. I just know it. I think that Paul probably disrupted his timetable somehow.
Then he'll have to come back, and he will go straight to Paul.
I hate to use Barbara and Paul as innocent bait, but since they didn't come forward with the truth, it's still our best way to nail Stenbeck once and for all.
Well, Barbara is hardly innocent. I mean, if she's known about this all along, why didn't she just come to us in the first place?
Come on, Margo. I mean, if you had a kid, would you want to put it... I'm sorry.
No, you're right. If I had a child, I'd do everything I could to protect it. Listen, let's just not put all our eggs in one basket, all right? Let's just keep an eye on Emily. You know, if she ran away like you think she did, the same way Paul did, he may be back.
Okay, we'll do that. And we better find Duncan before Stenbeck does. As long as he's out there, Duncan's still number one on the hit list.
Can I get some change, please? Thank you.
Charles, it's me.
Duncan, where the devil are you, man?
Oh, never mind. There's one of Oakdale's more charming spots down by the dock. Listen, I want you to meet me.
What?
I don't have time for small talk, lad. I want you to get Geraldine to pack me a bag.
Geraldine's gone, and Simon, too.
Gone where?
Well, I don't know. Their room was empty, and all their things were gone. I suppose when they believed you were guilty, they left, man.
Either that or they knew damn well I wasn't guilty. Maybe Shannon's been right all this time. Maybe they have been working for Stenbeck. Hold on, Charles.
And he confessed to being James Stenbeck's accomplice here in Oakdale. So it appears Duncan McKechnie, the Scottish importer who was being held on suspicion of these crimes, has been vindicated. Unfortunately, Mr. McKechnie's whereabouts are currently unknown, as he escaped from his holding cell yesterday after knocking out a guard.
Duncan, are you still there? Duncan!
Better go stand by your man, Jeannie.
If she makes a pass at Logan, I'll bop her one.
Where are you from, Loretta?
Well, I was born and raised in Lance Creek.
Yeah?
Other side of the creek, that is, not the town.
Yeah, right.
Oh, you all are so nice.
You know, I sure smell something mighty fine on the grill. I think those women are going to be bringing out that food soon.
Mm-hmm. Chow time.
Yeah, okay.
Well, you are a real pretty dancer, Miss Loretta.
Gosh, thanks. It was an honor to entertain at your wedding party. I sure do wish you and Grace all the best.
Oh, I appreciate that.
Maybe this wedding tomorrow will give Lance the right idea.
It's going to scare him silly. But I'll tell you one thing. I'm not going to wait around as long as Gracie did just to have some plain gold band on my finger.
Knowing Lance, there wouldn't be anything plain about it.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. I could tell. You're no regular pump boy. You got ambition, I bet.
Yeah, I do. I do have a lot of ambition. What about you? This is not what you do for a living.
Oh, heck no. See, I'm saving up my money to go to beauty school in Casper, and it won't be long. But you'd be surprised how many people want a girl to strip. Mostly bachelor parties for birthdays. You got a birthday coming up?
In a couple of months, but we probably won't be here by then. Hors d'oeuvre?
No. You handled that real well, honey.
I know. She's a very nice girl, isn't she?
What do you mean that we're not going to be here?
Well, who knows where we're going to be tomorrow, right?
Well, that would be a very nice birthday present, wouldn't it?
That there is a one-woman man, Mr. Whitaker. I got nowhere at all. You're going to give me the 50 anyway.
Oh. Loretta, honey, you mind if I borrow this for a sec?
Sure.
Thank you. Now, we got some people here in this room that thinks being married is all warm milk and curlers in bed. Well, I'm about to disavow you of that notion. Oh. Logan, honey, this is for you.
Oh, my goodness.
I know.
We don't have a reservation, but I thought we could just sit at the bar and grab a sandwich or something. How's that
Casey,
sound?
Yeah, it's not the tables. I have plenty of tables. It's just that, well...
You want to go someplace else?
No, I spent all evening on the hotline telling people not to run away from their problems, and I'm hungry.
Well, hey, I'll fix you a table, okay?
Thanks. You don't have to talk to him.
No, I need to. Why don't you go ahead, and I'll be there in a second, okay?
Okay, you got guts. Hi.
Listen, in case you're wondering, I did tell Casey what happened.
Well, I'm glad you have a good friend like Casey. I guess you know I spoke with your folks. They were more understanding than I had any reason to expect. Look, I thought you should know, Sabrina and I both realize that we can't go ahead with anything until we know that you're going to be okay.
I'll be okay. And I just wanted you to know that I don't want you or Sabrina, for that matter, to put your lives on hold because of me, all right?
It must be wonderful to have an older brother ready to do battle for you.
Well, you've got that wrong. Franny's gone to battle for me several times.
Well, there's obviously a lot of love in your family. I guess that's why you're such an open and giving person. Now, you take me, classic case of an only child from divorced parents. Selfish, slightly spoiled.
Well, not that I see.
Well, thanks for the compliment, but wait till you get to know me better.
That sounds nice.
Dr. Baldwin.
May I borrow Tom for one moment?
Oh, if I have to give him up.
Would you excuse me?
Excuse me.
Sure. You okay?
I will be.
Dr. Baldwin, may I join you for a moment?
Of course.
Thank you.
But I think I know what you're about to say.
Oh, really?
You're naturally concerned about your son. He's hurt, confused. In other words, he's very vulnerable. And I think that you're afraid he's going to set himself up for something on the rebound. I just want to assure you that our dinner tonight is nothing but a friendly dinner. Frankly, I'm too smart to get involved in a potentially dead-end relationship.
Well, I see. I suppose I have nothing to say to you then. If you will excuse me.
Stenbeck's ability to appear and disappear at will has got Interpol stumped, I'm afraid.
Well, he's no magician, Earl. He's had some help.
You mean Nick Costello?
And others. Some less willing, but just as effective. I can't really talk about it much more. I just want to tell you one thing. If you continue to dig into this case, don't trust anyone. Don't take any unnecessary risks.
Well, look who's talking about risks. You weren't even armed when you rescued Margot. You could have gotten hurt.
I did, Earl. But not by Nick Costello.
Nothing new on Nick. Shannon's on the phone with Jessica. The charges against Duncan have been formally dropped. So what do you say we go to my place for a beer and a back rub and whatever?
I need you.
You got me.
I tried to apologize for Tom. I mean, after all, he did come and risk his neck to save me, and then you walked into Nick's, and I went right to you. That's where I wanted to be.
Only we knew where Duncan was. It's ridiculous. You know, he obviously doesn't know that his name has been cleared. What if he's hanging out someplace where there are no radios, no newspapers, nothing but mooses?
Why would I do something like that, Marcy, when I'm a free man?
Duncan!
Oh. I thought I should make certain it was official. I ran into Officer Sullivan outside. He filled me in on the details.
Well, I guess there's nothing left to say, huh?
Oh, no, 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 no. You can apologize to Duncan, please.
Oh, well, I think I owe a few apologies myself. When I jumped ship, so to speak, I swam ashore and I hid under the docks, and one of your officers was unfortunate enough to discover me there. I'm afraid I left him a bit worse for the wear.
It's strange we didn't get a report on that.
Oh, good Lord, I hope I didn't do him any serious harm.
Well, did you recognize him? I mean, have you ever seen him before?
Aye, it was Nick Costello, the rookie. As a matter of fact, I took his firearm.
That's mine, all right.
Well, let's go, Sullivan. Oh, what's going on?
Never mind, what's... Shannon will explain.
Explain what?
Nick was James Stenbeck's contact. It turns out he was the one that planted all that evidence on you. The ruckle box, the phony ledgers, and the fingernails, the hair under the fingernails, and he's the one that killed George.
And Doris?
Yeah.
God, I wish I'd known that.
Well, I'm glad you didn't. Now let the police take care of it. They'll go after the right man this time, and hopefully that'll lead them to James Stenbeck. So you see, my love, you've got nothing more to do tonight.
Oh, yes, I do.
The office, so I'm going to go to bed right now.
All right, I'll join you in a minute. And then I'll let you know how sorry I was for making such a fuss earlier.
You are feeling better, aren't you?
Much.
Look, Meg, I want you to understand that everything I've done so that you and I can have a life here. All right?
I understand.
Good.
I still haven't even put away all your clothes yet. Oh, this jacket needs to go to the cleaners. Antonio, mm-hmm. Do you know that you've lost a button on this jacket?
And my blazer. I wonder how that happened.
I guess it would have been too easy to ask if we could have just found him out cold here.
Too easy.
I don't know if it means anything, but take a look at that.
brass button.
It's a brass button. It's off a blazer. A man's blazer, any blazer, maybe a woman's blazer. All buttons look alike.
And he was definitely not wearing a blazer the last time I saw Nick.
Sullivan is probably off some kid's jacket. He was down under the docks necking with his girlfriend, but go ahead, take it in.
Want me to radio in a report?
If it would make you feel better.
Right.
You ready for that beer in that back room?
Yes.
Me too. On one condition.
Oh, you're giving me conditions now?
Mm-hmm. When we get home,
yes.
I will make myself scarce and you call Tom. I know whatever happened at the Mona Lisa today has been bothering you, and you probably didn't get to thank him the way that you wanted to, so go ahead, thank him. I mean, you should clear that up. I can handle that. And besides, you'll sleep better. And I won't get all black and blue.
Oh. I really enjoyed tonight. Thanks, Tom.
I enjoyed it myself.
Oh, don't tell me you're going back to the office.
Well, the DA's work is never done. Besides, there's not much waiting for me at home.
Well, then I'll suggest an alternative. Why don't we go back to my place and have a nightcap?
Why not?
Wonderful.
Good to see you home and serving safe and sound.
Aye.
Good night.
Thanks, Charles. Good night.
Doc? What are you doing?
What's it look like I'm doing? I'm carrying my bride to bed.
Your bride?
Ah, well, you were. Once.
Oh, right. But, wait a minute. Do you remember where you laid all those booby traps?
What booby traps?
The ones that you warned us all about on pain of death. You mean all that talk about your new security system was all a bluff?
Listen, I wasn't about to risk harming some perfect innocent who happened to be snooping about on the island. Besides, as long as Stenbeck and his nasty crew thought they were going to be blown to bits, the bluff was effective.
But
no buts. And no more talk of Stenbeck.
Okay.
The danger's past, and you and I have the whole night together.
Yeah!
This portion of As the World Turns has been brought to you by Fleischmann's Margarines, 100% pure corn oil goodness and no cholesterol. Women's Fashions by Regina Porter. Join us tomorrow for the Emmy Award winner, As the World Turns.